According to legends, before Athens was the city we know of today, it was called Cecropia, named after its king, Cecrops. By the way, he was half man and half snake, because Greek mythology. But anyway, one day he called on to his people to vote for a patron god to dedicate the city to. The gods heard, and two of them were really interested in the position. The first one was Poseidon. He was like, "What's up, everybody? I'm Poseidon, brother of Zeus, god of the sea, so like, I'm pretty powerful. Check this out." And so he struck the ground with his trident, and water gushed out. People were like all excited because they had this new source of water, but then they realized it was salty, because Poseidon is the god of sea after all, not of fresh water or anything. And so Athena comes next. She goes, "Hey y'all, I'm the daughter of Zeus, I'm pretty powerful too. I'm a goddess of wisdom, crafts, strategic warfare, so like, I got lots of tricks up my sleeves, so here's my gift to you." And so, all of a sudden, an olive tree grew out of the ground. She's like, "Okay guys, this thing is super useful. You can use the wood to build houses, boats, whatever. You can eat the olives, make oil out of it, put it in your salad dressing. You can use the oil to light up your lamps and, you know, make your houses bright. Or you can even use it to moisturize, rub it all over your body so you look all nice and shiny for the Olympics. Trust me, this thing is amazing." And so now it was time to vote. And yes, contrary to what we know of actual Greek society, women were actually allowed to vote at this time, at least in this mythical story. But people were pretty divided, and it turns into this whole gender issue. So the men, they mostly worked off the sea as like fishermen, merchants, sailors, and whatever, so they favored Poseidon because they were closer to him. But the women, they mostly stayed inland, so they valued Athena's olive tree more. And as it turns out, they actually outnumbered the men. So they won, and therefore Athena won. The city was renamed Athens in her honor, and she became the city's reigning deity. Now, the story should have ended there, but you know, these gods, yeah, are super dramatic. So Poseidon, he was not taking things well at all. He was acting like this big sore loser. So when Athenians got out to the sea, they were no longer welcome. They were getting shipwrecked, their city was getting flooded, they'd have water shortages all the time. Things were just getting out of control. So the Athenians, they're like, "Oh crap guys, what are we gonna do? How do we make this stop?" And so they decided they could go to the Oracle of Delphi. Now this oracle, she's supposed to be able to like speak to the gods and relay their message to the people, but she's always like kind of cryptic with her answers, and people are never sure what she's talking about, and there's a gazillion ways to interpret her messages. And so what the Athenians got out of it was, one, they had to build a temple dedicated to Poseidon somewhere else in Athens so they would continue to worship him. And two, and this is a really sad one, in order to fully appease Poseidon and end his wrath, they had to punish all their women for voting for Athena. So they were stripped off of their citizenship, they could no longer vote or participate in politics, they pretty much lost all their rights. And that, unfortunately, is how this mythical story ends. Whether it was through Athena's guidance or not, we know historically that Athens flourished in the art, science, philosophy, and literature. You know, their works and ideas carries on to this day. Also, whether having reconciled with Poseidon had anything to do with it or not, we also know that Athens grew a powerful navy that dominated the Mediterranean. Their empire under the Delian League spanned the whole Aegean Sea, and it reached as far out as the Black Sea. As in the case in most of history, glory comes at a price. The Athenian democracy that we celebrate today was far from an equal society, and beyond these myths and legends, we know historically that women were excluded in Athenian society. They couldn't vote, they couldn't own property, they weren't even allowed to watch the Olympics.